Hi there! This video will show you how to design on a display box Dieline template. While adding your design to the Dieline template, it can be helpful to refer back to the display box orientation guide to see how you should place your design elements. To show you how to add your design to a display box Dieline template, let's use this PackMojo box as a base and add some additional elements. As you can see, this box has some logo and text elements on several panels. Display boxes are made using one paperboard that is folded and glued to form your box. When adding your designs to the Dieline template, please remember to account for bleeds, meaning artwork at the edge should extend beyond the Dieline. For display boxes without dust flaps, there will be a removable area separated by a perforated line for you to transform your box into a display case for your products. Generally, designs on all panels will stay in the same orientation. As an exception, for the top part of the lid seen here as display front, designs should be inverted. This is because when you transform your box, the lid will be folded in half to create a display flap, thus inverting your design. To ensure that your designs translate well to display units, make sure to put your designs on either the display front or back, and not in the middle of the lid, where the fold line is. Our display boxes use an auto bottom lock. Therefore, for the bottom flaps, there are sections that will be hidden and overlapping. To avoid covering important details, you may want to refrain from putting designs in the corners as they will be hidden. Instead, put the details towards the center, or even better, on the main parts of the box, such as the side walls. For display boxes without dust flaps, areas above the perforated line on the side walls and front walls will be removed when you transform your box into a display unit. Thus, make sure to keep the designs you want on your final display away from this area. Keep logos and texts away from the perforated line on the front of the box. Ideally, if there are any logos and text, you want to keep it on the front wall, in between the bottom edge and the perforated line. If you opt to transform your box into a display unit, do note that the side flaps will be removed as well. When you're done designing, double-check it with the Dieline orientation guide to make sure that everything is in the correct location and orientation. To learn more about adding logos, vectorizing text, or embedding images, click on the link in the description or head to our website for more design tips. Happy designing!